Hello and welcome back to the KCC channel. I'm Rob and today we have some FHOA. Let's jump right in. This story comes to us from Rakshas, beat HOA with their own rules. I recently bought a house in a new development. I knew there was an HOA before going in, but unfortunately, due to my personal circumstances and how hard it is to find a house here in Florida, I had no choice about the matter, as much as I loathe HOAs. It's my intention to put up with their BS for 2 to 3 years, dig myself out, and move far away to a place that never heard about HOAs. This being a new community, the builder is currently responsible for a lot of questionable decisions. One being planting a magnolia tree in the backyards of all the houses. For anyone that does not know, magnolia trees grow big. 30 to 40 feet in height is considered normal. Now, this being Florida, I didn't want such a huge tree in my yard near my house, especially during hurricane season. The builder said I would have to take it up with the HOA to replace the tree, as the area I live in requires a tree in the backyard. Okay, no problem. I moved in and sent a request through the HOA property management website to replace the magnolia tree with a dwarf citrus tree. May as well get some fruits if I must have a tree in the backyard. They responded, nope, I can only replace the tree from their approved list, conveniently attached. I scoured their list, not a single fruit in the list. I was beyond pissed. I read that list up and down, even put it through ChatGPT to see if I was missing anything. No fruit tree or plants. Okay, how about insect repellent plants? None of those either. To say I was beyond pissed is putting it mildly. I had read their CCNRs before moving in, so I had an idea of what I was getting into. I stewed on it for a couple days and was deciding to get a shrub from their approved list when I read their CCNRs one more time. I found this gem. 4.58 Florida friendly and drought tolerant plants and landscaping materials. Notwithstanding any provision to the contrary in the governing documents, the association shall not be permitted to prohibit the use of Florida friendly or drought tolerant plants and landscaping materials within the community. I copied it and sent it to the property management company, saying I would like to replace the magnolia plant with a Florida-friendly plant as per the above section in the CCNR. Radio silence for a few days. I do believe I broke their little petty brains. Then I got the notice that my request was approved. I will gleefully go rip that magnolia tree out the yard now and plant a grapefruit tree. I have since spoken with some of my new neighbors, and they have all expressed a desire to remove the magnolia tree from their yards for various reasons. I will gleefully point out the section of the CCNRs that they should read. Jumping down to the comment section on this one, there's one from a user called MotherAthlete2998. It says, I have a friend in Alabama who had a magnolia tree in his front yard. It was well established, mature, and huge. Then, he found out what a magnolia's root system did to the foundation of his home. This is one tree I would never put on my plot of land. I believe the root system is twice the size underground of what is seen above ground. Wow, that's crazy. So definitely not a tree you'd want growing very close to your house, and I can see why OP would want to get rid of that there. This story just tells us that if you're in an HOA, you need to read all of the HOA documentation, because that will give you the ammo to take on the HOA themselves. Because I can bet you some of the people on the HOA board haven't read through it all themselves. I bet. This story comes to us from Noel Organization 1286, board president, a hoarder, and storing trash under staircase. My HOA is horrible. They do not want election rules, refuse to take accountability for giving fraudulent financials, and gave a crook of a manager a raise instead of canceling his contract. At the last meeting, they were talking about fining people for leaving items under their storage boxes instead of inside. Mind you, the inside of the storage boxes has leaks that the HOA has not fixed for more than 3 years. I am generally a peaceful person, but this HOA has me livid. I feel my blood boil. I snapped, I lost my mind. So I decided to do a cleanup of the property. I went first to where the contractor left behind their trash, the unusable remnants of a fountain that was removed more than 2 years ago. I collected the musty towel that one previous board member, who doesn't let others use the spa, leaves for himself when he goes swimming, put it in the trash. I took debris of planters, I took the sliding door that has been leaning against the building for literally 1 year. I removed the luggage that was left for someone to take and walked it to Goodwill. Then I did the worst thing. I went beneath the staircase in the common area where the president stores her items that no longer fit in the condo. I knew it was hers, but I knew I could pretend it was trash. She had plastic containers and trash bags, like ate a grocery store salad, washed the container and kept it. She has foam for going under the carpet. She had broken glass. I took it all. I went to the elevator room. I removed the passive-aggressive rules the previous board had left in the entryway, covering the whole bulletin board. They were not allowing others to post and had all these rules that were in plastic but had been there so long they had faded. I ripped it all out. I threw it all away. It was the best feeling in the world. It was like a drug. And then she had a meltdown and sent me an email called Cease and Desist from Placing Junk in Front of Cobro Complex. It has accusations that I was collecting personal materials and called the association's trash company. I think it's hilarious, and I know they will not be happy with me, and I lost political power, but honestly, FHOA, what a scam. Jumping down to the comment section on this one, there's one from a user called OKEntertainer7721. It says, "You can also hit her with the fact that you can't store things under the stairs. The fire marshal might like to know about that." Okay, I'm not up on my rules as far as the fire marshal is concerned, but why would stuff under stairs have any impact on the fire marshal or getting out of a building in case of a fire? It's not blocking the stairs, so that part I'm not understanding, and I'd love it if you guys would comment down below. The other thing here is, it just seems to me like OP did a whole bunch of cleaning up the HOA for free. So, like, he did their work without being asked to. This story comes to us from MermaidFL407. This is how I know my HOA is a joke. FHOA. A few weeks ago, I posted about receiving another letter from my HOA about trimming trees and how they never provide me photos or direction of which branches they want removed when I ask. That letter also included that I needed to mow my yard every week and clean up debris, which I do. I tried calling a couple of tree companies for a quote, but no one called back except for one, but they didn't give a quote after he looked at it. So all I did was pull down some of the moss and had a couple of bags I raked from my flower bed to tidy it up and mowed my yard like usual. So fast forward to now and I get the second notice. Funny how this second notice doesn't mention the tree at all when I didn't even trim it, but they still mention the debris and mowing the yard even though I did do that. I seriously can't with this HOA. No matter what I do, it's never good enough. I sent a reply about how I am indeed doing my yard work every week. I really have no idea how to satisfy them if they're not providing photos or being specific. And I definitely don't have control if they see my yard every time the grass grows back. This is ridiculous. What am I supposed to do now? Jumping down to the comment section on this one, we have a user that wrote out a response to the HOA. The user is called LivingInternet4924. And they said, "I acknowledge receipt of your letter. I am completing yard work tasks regularly and find myself in a position where I am unsure of what specific issues you're seeing with the yard. I formally request an in-person meeting with the issuer of this notice to walk through the yard with me and specifically point out the causes for concern. In the alternative, a thoroughly detailed letter with pictures where the offending areas are circled would suffice. Vague descriptions do not provide me the required opportunity to cure and therefore do not meet the requirements of the governing documents and rules and regulations. If I do not receive the necessary clarification, I will disregard your prior notices as moot and take that silence as evidence I've fixed the issue. This is what I'd write. Assuming everything in this is true and you have reviewed the governing docs to know what the requirements are on lawns, notices, and the right to cure. I don't know, this one's kind of weird because it seems like maybe they're giving the notice to the wrong person. If OP's keeping up on their property, then there's no reason for them to be getting it. But maybe OP needs to take a close look at their neighbors, because maybe the HOA has the address wrong that they're sending it to. If OP continues to get these though, the letter that the commenter wrote is a great idea, but I would take it to a lawyer and have them send it to the HOA. It's not very expensive to get a lawyer just to send one letter, especially if you've already typed it up. They just need to put it on their letterhead, and it's not going to be that expensive at all. That would put them on notice that there is a lawyer involved, and that will probably stop the letters very quickly. This story comes to us from Steve It Steve. Will I be the butthole for reporting an HOA member to the board for yelling at my friend about a mailbox color violation on my property? I, 19 male, and mom live in an HOA community that dictates the color of mailboxes. They must be black. While I recently had to put a new one in after the door broke off our old one, while I did not know about the rule and put in a white mailbox. Fast forward to this afternoon, a retired man who lives in the neighborhood recently volunteered to help the board enforce violations. He does a drive every few weeks to check up on houses. Well, today he went down my street as my friend, 19 male, pulled in the drive to work with me in my basement. He texts me he is here. Before he made it up to my door, the friend told me the HOA dude walks up to him and starts to ask him questions. Says he is in direct violation of an HOA code. My friend tells him he does not live there and HOA dude does not buy it. It's been a few minutes now, so I assume I forgot to unlock the door and he's stuck outside. When I open the door, I hear the HOA dude pulling the "Do you know who I am?" card. He's raising his voice when I butt in, also not knowing much about him. He goes off about the mailbox to me and how it's making the neighborhood look bad. I told him I'm unaware of it and will talk to my mom about painting it when she gets off work. His tone shifted there. He legitimately thought two 19-year-old kids owned a $300,000 house. Had no idea my mom owned it. Things then go full bonkers mode. Dude started to cover his tracks to me, saying that my friend was the one with the attitude and sarcastically answering questions, and was full of crap. In reality, my friend was confused on why some dude approached him talking about a mailbox. He calls us violators and leaves. We both just laughed. I asked my mom on what to do and she said it's up to me since I'm an adult now. I'm leaning towards reporting the guy due to his condescending tone, unprofessional behavior, and raising his voice at my friend who was genuinely just very confused about what's going on. I don't think he even knows what an HOA is. My friend and I joked about it once he left, but still, I don't want another person in our neighborhood to get yelled at like that. I wish one of us had taken a video to show as evidence of behavior. Most of the board is actually quite reasonable, so I could see him getting kicked out if I do report him. So, will I be the butthole for reporting his behavior? Jumping down to the comment section on this one, there's one from a user called Dittohead Forever. It says, "You will not be the butthole, but you also wouldn't be gaining anything. Odds are the HOA is run by like-minded people with like-minded attitudes who are perfectly fine with their Barney Fife enforcer and his belligerent attitude." Yeah, I was thinking this way as well. OP, don't make a stink over something as small as painting your mailbox. I mean, you didn't know about the rules. You are in violation. Yeah, that guy's being a bit of a dick, but you know what? Some people are just dicks. That's how it goes. If it were a bigger issue, I'd take it up with the HOA, but in this case, I'd probably leave it alone, because if you stir that pot, they might just find a whole bunch more violations to put on you about other things on your home.